Hey everyone, my name is Sam and I'm a senior product designer here at Appcues. And today I want to show you how to build an awesome mobile onboarding flow to quickly communicate the value of your app to your customers. And the best part is, it only takes a few minutes and there's no developer required. Today I'm going to build this flow in DemoQueues Android. And I'm going to name this onboarding flow number one. So I'm gonna create that. All right, so I'm gonna come now into the mobile builder and I'm gonna see here that I have four different options at the moment to add a modal. Since today I'm gonna be making a three-step flow that's a carousel, I'm gonna go with a full screen modal. This will really grab users' attention and help them to focus on the things that I want them to focus on. And it's already laid out in a pretty nice way. This is laid out quite similarly to how I'm gonna end up building it. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change the modal color to one of my brand colors that's also pretty light, but it just helps users to feel a little bit more at home in my app. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn off the close X since I'm gonna be making my own dismiss button and I don't need that one. This one's nice, but it's just not what I want for this current modal. Next, I'm gonna upload my image. So I'm gonna go and upload this gift image here. Did you know that 75% of users abandon an app after day one? Well, I don't want that to happen with my app. I want to entice them to stick around. So I'm gonna give them 100 gigabytes of data free forever. And we'll put some text in here as well. All right, that's looking nice. Now, the size, proportion, and styling for some of these elements isn't quite how I want it yet. So I'm gonna change this image and I'm gonna make sure that it's always 500 pixels tall. And I'd like all the images in this flow to occupy the same amount of space. Now, this is looking a little bit too zoomed in. So I'm gonna change this from fill to fit. And now no part of the image is gonna get cut off. And I'm gonna change the style of my text. I'm gonna change the font to Moolish, which is my app font. And that's one of the neat things about the Appcues builder is I can add any custom font that's in my app just by hitting add custom font and typing in the name of the font as it appears in my app. All right, so finally, this button isn't quite where I want it. So I'm gonna actually move this button up top here. One best practice that I'll give you is anytime you're building an onboarding flow, you do wanna give your users a way to skip it. Some of your users might have already used your app before, maybe they're just reinstalling it on a new device. So you wanna let them skip the flow if they're already power users. At the same time, you don't want to make the skip button too easily accessible in case someone taps it by mistake. So I'm going to put this in the top right corner. We're going to change the alignment here. So we're going to right justify this. And now I'm going to change the color of the button to be completely transparent. And I'm going to change the text to be Moolish. And I'm going to change the text color to be my primary blue. So now it's up there, it's nice and subtle, but users can still skip the flow if they want to. So I actually don't want this to say next, I want it to say skip. And I want this action to not go to the next step, I want this to actually dismiss the whole flow. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clone this step, and so everything is exactly as I want it, but I just wanna change up now the images. So I'll open up the next image here, which is this sync.png. And I like how this is looking good, but I actually want to give it some margin so that it's not touching the edge of the screen. So I'm going to give it about 30 pixels of margin on either side, and then that way it's nice and centered. I'm going to change the text now. So that's looking good. That was super easy. Once I set the first modal up, I can just easily swap out a few elements on the second one, and it just looks awesome. Now you'll notice here that since this is a carousel, I've got these step indicators on the bottom. Well, I wanna customize those as well so that they match my brand. So I'm gonna use this blue that's part of my brand palette. Then I'm gonna use it again for the inactive state. But for this inactive state, I want it to have half transparency, 50% transparency. So I'm gonna lower this down here and I'm gonna add just one more step. For an onboarding flow, anywhere from 3 to 7 steps is a good number to have. You don't wanna overwhelm users with information. So I'm gonna add one more step to this flow. And this last one's actually gonna be a screenshot from my app. It's nothing fancy, it's just a basic file storage app. But this way I can communicate to users, this is the main feature that you came to this app for, to store all your files. because this is the last step in this flow, I'm gonna have a big call to action here that says, get started. And I'm gonna change the color of this button to my primary color. I'm gonna change the font to Moolish. And I'm gonna add a little bit of margin between the button and the text above it. I'm gonna go 24 pixels just so that there's a little bit more space. I'm also gonna change the button's width so that it's 300 pixels across because I want it to be very easy to click for my users. And then this button action is just gonna go to the next step as well, which by default is gonna close the flow. So there's no steps after this one. Next step is just gonna dismiss it. And this is also gonna stay there, but I'm just gonna call it close now because we've reached the end of the flow. Now I've built this awesome flow. So now I actually wanna test it out. Now I actually wanna see it on my device in my app. So one option that I have here is I could just simply hit preview flow and then I could bring up my phone and scan this QR code. But for the purpose of today's video, I'm actually gonna target and publish this and walk you through how I'll do that. So I'm gonna hit target and publish. And now I'm gonna get taken back to Appcues Studio. So here I have all kinds of options for how I can target this flow. So I could target it to a specific app version, a specific audience. I could trigger it off a certain event. Because this is an onboarding flow, I'm gonna trigger it when users start an app session. And I want all users to see this. And I'm gonna show it once since it's an onboarding flow. And now I'm just gonna come up here and hit publish. And now let's take a look in my app. And look at that. Success. And now I'll close it. And there we are. We're back in the app. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it's been helpful for you. And stay tuned for more tips and tricks on how to get the most out of Appcues Mobile.